So because I've changed this sucker around a bit, I've added so many different little things to it. I think I've extended the nose since last time. I've done a lot. I did kind of want to just test fly it just to make sure it was going to work properly. I know that we knew the Spartacus, the first shuttle, flew just fine, but this new one, I want to make sure that, how am I going to do this? I want to make sure that it's going to work with a payload in it, because we haven't necessarily tested that. So I'm going to do the Mark 2-A. So I guess this would be the A-A save, and we need to make a Mark B and replace this. Okay, so this is the B variant. I'm going to redo everything here. I guess that's what happens when I just kind of throw things on. I literally throw it on the side of my spacecraft. That way I'm able to remember to put things back on. Okay, so we got this. We need a payload of some sort just to test out, so it doesn't really matter what it is. So we'll just add utility. We will go to the... Oh, heck, where is it? I know it's in here somewhere. It's the little attachment thing. The attachment. Wow, I literally can't find it. It's under utility? Oh, it might be under structural at the end. Yeah, it is. Okay. So we'll do that. We only want one of these. And if we hold Alt and flip it around or not. Okay, well, let's hit C. X. I don't know. All the buttons. Sure, that'll work. And I just want to do a decoupler. Don't really need it. Gonna do it anyways. Like I said, this is a test payload. And we'll do... I don't know. I'll attach one of those. And... maybe just some science stuff. Whoops. Dun, dun. Okay. And then we will just get some struts. So under structural, it's a weird word. Okay, let's go connect that so it's not bouncing around. I am going to action groups, custom three. Okay, I am going to go bump, bump, bump. By the way, you can alt left click, and it'll select all of them. So toggle. Okay, so that should all work. So let's close these. Ink, and nice. Oh, and the last thing I was going to do is I was going to get rid of this. Like so. And instead, I was just going to put on one of these and try that out. That was the other thing I wanted to do. It's got a lot more power and it's kind of the same size. So, why not? Okay, so that decoupler's in there. I don't want it in there. Sure, that'll work for now. So, save, launch. Hopefully this won't just explode. I think the weight on the three entrants versus the one is comparable. I think it's at least equal, if not just slightly more, so it shouldn't be too heavy. Oh, it is dark. Well, let's just let's quick save and let's warp time real quick just so we can get some light. There we go. Nice. Launch. Sounds cool. I actually never set an action group for the engine to toggle a switch. So I'll have to do that once I am back in the crafting thing. I don't remember the name of it. Look, the hangar. There we go. That's the word I was looking for. This engine may bounce against the ground. I feel like I'm going fast enough to... Whoa! Okay, well, maybe it's a bit heavier with the payload compared to the last one, so it's having a hard time launching. Probably just actually really need to readjust the landing gear, which is probably the main thing, but let's slow ourselves down a little bit. So I'm going to try a maneuvering node here, or a maneuvering thing, just to make sure that it's just not going to explode upon itself when I start turning. Because the whole not necessarily... Oop, not necessarily having the same weight ratio as before can really change things. It looks like it's fine. It definitely looks like this is fine. Yeah, it's not freaking out. It's actually turning quite well. It's maneuvering quite well. It's maneuvering better than before, which is a good sign. We will air brakes. Whoa, air brakes really adjusted my... Oh, turn off the air brakes quickly. Whoa. Whoa. Okay. I think I'm going to have to make another pass. That really adjusted my aerodynamics. It pulls to... Oh, okay, that's because... Okay, that's fine. Okay, so we're going to revert back to the hangar. See, this is why we test things, to make sure that things are working properly. Clearly, they were not. Okay, first things first. Weight and lift. We want our landing gear to be closer to our center of mass. We might just flip backwards, but that it might be just enough. Okay, so there's that. And then I also want to go to action groups. Want to go to 2, which is my air brakes. Want to add that. Add that. And I want to go to 1 to switch mode on that engine. Okay, save, relaunch, make sure everything works. And then this sucker's good to start making some resupply missions. This one in particular, this shuttle, is going to be really important when we get our second space station up and running. Because that one will need manned like missions to and from, in order to put more people on the space station, to rotate people out, and to resupply it with minor supplies. So this in particular, this one shuttle, is going to be used a significant amount in our future missions to that space station in particular. So, how fast do I need to go in order to start launch, or in order to stop my lift? Let's try now. Okay. Oh, jeez. Abort! Brakes! That never happened. In fact, what I'm going to do real quick is I'm going to revert to spaceplane hangar. You're going to notice a little trick here, if I can get it to work properly, which is to... I might be able to do it with wheels, actually. It's uncommon to be able to do it, but I might be able to. Whoop. Okay. No. Back. So I want to put 2 of them on, like so. Aha! Maybe face it in a bit more. Like that. So those wheels should never touch on liftoff, but on landing, it'll make sure that I'm not bashing my massive rocket into the ground. And it will also make sure that while I'm landing, you know, if I have to make an abort landing and land somewhere difficult, that that's not going to cause any issues. It does, however, look like it counters the weight just enough to put it on its back wheel. So we'll see if it even takes off. I may just need to move this set of landing gear back just like an inch or two. That may do it. I know people put like struts, like just a small strut on the back. I feel that's kind of cheating. I don't know about that. Oop. Okay, so they weren't on the ground until just now. Nope. No, oh, that front wheel is off, but the rest of it isn't. Okay, that's fine. Okay, revert to spaceplane hangar. The problem is if we have to land outside of the space center at any point and we want to take back off again, that's never going to happen with those wheels on the back. So I want to go back to center of mass, center of lift. And I want to just line this up correctly. That should do it. Let's try again one last time. Still, that front wheel is a little off the ground, which has me a little worried. See, it's like not necessarily suspend, or it's suspended above the ground a little bit. I don't know what the weight ratio here is compared to the other one, but I know that this rocket, if it hits the ground, it's just going to blow up. So I want to definitely be a bit more careful and mindful of my butt. So that way it's not scratching the bottom of the ground. Oh, a little lift. Ah, there we go. See, I think we just need to be a bit more gentle. Let's turn that up. Let's put our lights on so we can kind of see what's going on here. Okay, so this looks like it's doing just fine. If I switch engines again, doing just fine. In fact, I'm gaining a lot of speed here. And I'm kind of okay with that, just for the time being. So we're going to switch back over. And I'm going to drop my throttle. I do like how the thing like wobbles. It's pretty cool. Let's see about opening our payload. Make sure that's not wobbling around. Yeah, that's fine. Of course, our space shuttle still has the same wobble problem as it did before. You know what? Let's slow down a bit. I want to get below 200 meters a second here. There we go. Which will allow me to then turn back around and get back to the space center. Now you got to remember our Kerbals and Project Destiny all have experience with these kind of cargo bay doors before because they built the Trident and its equivalent. So that way the military could have potential strike aircraft and they had to do bomb bay doors with that. So at the same time, they were dealing with, you know, the same kind of physics with that and how the weight ratio works. So we have some experience in that. So it makes it a bit easier when creating a shuttle that needs to carry a load of junk up to a space station. Now, the thing that I want to keep out or keep my eyes out for in the future is when we're... Okay, it's got our engine. When we're flying the sucker around later, I want to make sure that re-entry isn't as bad as before. So I'm definitely going to have to test that in my free time. Okay, brakes. Okay. Whoa. Good effort, guys, on the simulator. That was all simulator work. I definitely need to figure something out about this massive engine. Maybe we should just go back to using the 3, because we know the 3 work just fine. That probably will be a thing that we end up doing. Either way, it works quite well with the different little adjustments that I've made to the landing gear, to the little side wings and everything. I'm liking it quite a bit. Cool, so we're going to save this. We're going to go back. I want to go back to the vehicle bay, I wanted to show you guys just a brief glimpse at the space station before I alter it some more. So just kind of give you an idea of what I'm doing. What did I name it? I named it Station 1 because I don't have a name for it yet. But I'm trying to, like, pattern it out, right? So these are all inflatable, like, sections of a space station. So, like, this, for instance, is the habitation ring, which is where the Kerbals sleep. This is the habitation module. Then there's a aeroponics module and a bio lab. So basically, these three things, the agricultural module, the bio lab, and the aeroponics module, they all create food. So this is, like, the food portion. This is the where the Kerbals live portion. This is the command structure. But I want to have, like, another one coming off that has all the construction portion of it. So you can have these things that basically make stuff for you on these, like, space stations. But this is an easy way to start getting into the groove of creating outer space bases, because when we make our moon base and our Minmus base and our Duna base and all these things, it will be a similar layout on how we do things. Like, it'll have an aeroponics, a biolab, a habitation module, but there'll be actual structures that we land on the planet. So it's kind of interesting, but this is my, I don't know how, if I'm going to keep it on this layout. I'll probably change it, actually. Either way, each of these pretty much need to be flown up individually, so it's going to be kind of difficult. And I need, maybe I should just make adjustments to that now. I think I should. Okay, I'm going to try to come up with a better layout for this, and then we'll check in on our telescope afterwards and be able to kind of figure out what's going on in the rest of the galaxy here, because we haven't really looked at too much.